In September 2018, ABS-CBN aired a Panaloto segment on the agricultural business of pastry chef turned farmer Dexter Villamin. He was lauded as an overseas Filipino worker turned farming advocate championing Batangas or Angas beef.
May galing ang magsasakang Pilipino, ngunit napag-iiwanan tayo.
So dahil lang karamihan sa ating mga kababayan ay mas pinipili pa yung umalis ng bansa sa halip na pagyamanin ang ating sarili.
He was idealistic and eloquent, something many DV Boer investors and sub-farm owners say was the key reason they invested in the business.
Ang vision ko dito sa farm ay maipakilala sa mga Pilipino ang tunay na yaman ng ating bansa, no, sa pamamagitan ng agrikultura.
But fast forward to 2020, the farm Villamin started in 2014 has been flagged by the Securities and Exchange Commission for selling paiwi or livestock breeding investment securities without a proper license. Investors in the paiwi scheme are complaining of delayed payouts. Sub farms, which paid hefty fees to help do the breeding and caring of the livestock, are complaining of lost profits and investment. Some claim Villamin has become extravagant, pointing to a statue of himself erected in the middle of his farm in Batangas. Villamin's camp has dismissed those allegations, adding the statue was a gift. But Villamin himself has admitted to the delayed payments, and he could not give ABS-CBN a definite timetable for the resumption of payouts. Still, he insists his business model is not at fault. His spokesperson says it is possible Villamin is the victim of a smear campaign.
Dahil pioneer ang DV Boer in the business of the paiwi program, siyempre, success goes along with some people who envy your success. The company is not hiding anything. The management, the officials of the company is not hiding. They are here. They are working to sort out the problem.
However, ABS-CBN continues to receive complaints from more and more sub-farms and paiwi investors who've sunk millions of their hard-earned pesos into DV Boer. Many of them are overseas Filipino workers as well, just like Villamin was, stuck abroad with limited options on how to recoup their money. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.